at the Map Veto and find out where they've decided to butt heads. Club is where we're going
to
be.
25 seconds left, and all of a sudden, Liquid, they have been able to equal things up. Trades back and forth. Partlu's now going to go down as well. And it's Liquid that are falling by the wayside early here. Empire's attack just flawless towards the end of the round. It does take a cheeky shot at it. Moringa not going to change position, though. They now know where he's holding. 20 seconds left. Partlu, though, with the Nitro Cell kill. Unfortunately, though, over towards 9, he does get taken down. PSK can still not find that opening kill for himself. And Empire will take round number 4. Gotta respect this, though, from PSK. Despite a sluggish start, he's happy to just keep being involved. He's now got 2 for the round with 12 seconds left. We're into red time. It's time to go. Shepard does make the push in, but Moringa with a pixel will stop the plant. A sexy cake will take out Scyther, and Liquid take the round.
Moringa on round.
Although it is still a 5v5, it just comes down to who can hit their shots.
And Liquid haven't cleared out. Dan, he could go huge. That's the diffuser dropped. Time ticking down. He doubles for a second. 2 players low for Liquid, and this is not going to go well for them. Scyther surely can get in on the action, but no, get shut down. Dan doing all of the work.
Now they've also got garage control. Deal with always. Don't lose any more players.
This is a devastating position for Empire. Liquid stamping their authority in this round. They just need to close it out, but Joystick's still in the server. Don't discount this man.
Signs of life for this match. It's not all over just yet. Neither is this round. Shepherd with a nice frag onto Moringa, but there's a player pushing up top red stairs, and they obviously need to deal with Joystick running around. Turn around onto Palu. Sit down. 360 no-scope, and then a bit of damage to PSK's foot.
He might be able to find one more with Liquid quite low, but surely he gets traded. No, he doesn't. The player on the window doesn't find that pick. This could be Empire's opportunity. I think it will be. Sexy Cake, he's left in the one versus X scenario, but he can't convert. Empire take round number 11. They close out the map. The Russians are activated.
Are going to be playing, and it looks as if it will be Consulate.
To play inside of that bathroom area. He's now going to go for a bit of a peek, but Palu does shut him down. Bullet is now going to be pushing down yellow stairs. He's going to come into a nice little pinch here set up by Liquid. Kills start to fly. Souls, he's the last man standing, but the plant is going down. He's going to extend the time and put Souls in a bit of a clutch situation. He's been here before. He finds one, but it is not enough. The plant is going to be imminent. Sexcake trying to get it down. All 10 players still alive. The covering fire from Moringa. That C4 is going to be dead. The covering fire from his teammates is second to none. Cameraman, he's on the echo. He is the last man standing. The plant was going down. Parley with the swing from yellow.
Still here, and oh, Cameraman, unlucky with the timing, comes up at the wrong time. And Nesk, he's in almost the same position that Nesk was.
Parley's in a tough spot here. He's able to swing 5-1. How does he do it? He does get... There are only 25 seconds left. What have you just done, Moringa? Cyber, it's your time to go massive. You've just got to try and hold on. He doesn't have the intel. Moringa comes in. He didn't get the angle that he quite wanted. Bullet has traded out there over onto Parley. Sexy Kate with a nice kill onto the bottom of Big Door. Now going to be able to challenge in onto Meeting as well, but Cyber comes in with a big frag over onto Moringa. 2 for Liquid. Are they going to be able to hold on here? The diffuser's cold on the ground. Sexy Cake's on for a triple kill. He's trying to run away. What have we just seen? The diffuser was on the ground. Sexy Cake was out of ammo. Down. Cyber instead can try and find the angle, and Will with a swing. This is a must-win engagement here for Sexy Cake. He's got to essentially fight his way out of a box. He's going to find one onto Bullet. The push didn't come at either side. PSK with the Nitro Cell. Sexy Cake eventually gets taken down. Obviously, it's not the time really to be hopping in them now. The opportunity for intel was there, but it will not be found. PSK with that final kill. Liquid, they take the match here on Consulate against FaZe.
Liquid.
We're going to get a chalet out here.
From the earlier match against Liquid, but need to bounce back themselves. Bullet just going to get straight into Bar. And just gets a big tag. Sky's going to get finished off by Souls. Push from FaZe, very aggressive. The pressure mounting onto Mint. He's got not much of a chance. And in the end, very quick, clean, and flawless from FaZe. And just after eliminating Mint, Sky's is very, very precarious position.
Solid drone economy still available for FaZe. Souls finds one. Smokes will head out as FaZe prep for the plant.
Holds that shelf position and then takes off the head of NJR. Piper, unfortunately, doesn't have it in Bullet. Can push in. Oh no, never mind. Just get stopped immediately. Dark Zero about to pick up their first win of a round here for 6 Invitational. Nice shot from Souls. Gets thrown down. That's probably not what you should be shooting at with 3 seconds left in the round. Dark Zero. This doesn't turn into a bit of a choke here. Long way to go, but Eclipse just catching Astro.
Oh, mid.
Down those trophy stairs, here comes the Blitz. And here comes... Whoa, hang on. Darkseer have just lost all their players, by the way, in the last 10 seconds. We haven't even seen the round, and it's over.
They look like they're in such a great position, but FaZe, they just melt them as they enter in towards the side.
Well, and off of that flanking presence from FaZe. Never mind. Well, he did. He lost his fight to Skies. Hyper then catches out Astro. Mint, it's go time now for Dark Zero. They got the numbers.
Oh!
That Nitrous ult, though, from Cyber. 2 versus 1, 3 seconds left. It's NJR, though, who gets the kill. I thought maybe something magical was suddenly, maybe it's slipping from Dark Zero. Cyber, surely, over at the mezzanine. Quite literally just watches one of them. Oh, what a save from Skies! Literally from the sky. It's down to the site now. FaZe defending vigorously. Hyper's low. Eclipse is down. Skies is basically the last one standing. Has to stick the diffuser. He doesn't. I thought maybe he salvaged the round. FaZe win out 7-4 on Chalet.
And it is going to be Chalet. Back to back.
Iagator has been able to creep his way up, puts a man in a tight corner, and as soon as they get the read, they get the head too. 4 versus 4. CDZ are trying to pull themselves back round, drop one more. He's going to stick it the whole way round, puts himself in a post plot, and now he's able to get picked up. No! Anaton dropped by Skies on the swing round. One more, Skies. If you're going to stick the plant, well, I'm going to try and stick the defuse. DZ, take the first round.
Smoke, they make sure the rotation on the bedroom is slipped, but they slip through. Wamai, 5 seconds. They have to have the confidence to try to lock it down. Eclipse just has to get this one. He gets it. He drops it. He goes. Oh, he doesn't find it. Suzu C. We talk of Hail Marys.
Skies is trying to hold on, but Monty's gone deep. Monty's gone for pressure, and Monty has gone for blood, but it's suddenly a 1 versus 3. Galarada held deep, stacked him up, knocked him down, and Cyclops find their third.
As NGR and Mint taking some firefights themselves.
Corner, but he's exceptionally low health, so his next fight, well, it doesn't last very long, and there's one more. Hyper with a double, goes for the trip, can't quite find it. Anaton.
Now we find ourselves in a post-plant situation, one of the two standing. Well, it's Blitz, Gatorada. As Skies goes a little bit wider, there's the drop round the corner, gets him blind, but Mint opens the round and then says, oh, that's where you got to from the bathroom.
This looks like they might be setting up for a lot of pace here as they open the door. Gone six, goodbye. Hyper's inside sight, drops one. Look at the backside there. They're already in. The winery is all theirs. But Anaton from above gets the man with the diffuser. The defender's trying to keep back ground. NJR, though, has the lockdown on Anaton. But one of the people in that selection is a Blitz. Another one is NJR, who's going for his third here. Finds it, Dark Zero. Find their first win.
Able to take it down. Our son gone six in their hands. I'm like, what is this going to be? Is there a piece of utility they want to clear? But no.
Oh, you're taking C9 to Consulate.
He's going to scamper off. Also worth noting that a lot of times we'll see the mute. Nice shot. One toxic canister left. He's throwing it out, but he's missed it. So there's still one in his pocket if need be. Harp doubled up on in numbers, and C9 are going to attempt the retake on that main floor. Down on the diffuser, there's NV Taylor. Looks for one, doesn't get the other, so Gatorano will try his best. He takes out the Lord. SMG-11 in hand, but he cannot be stopped as Harper hops on. It's the second round in a row that they've been good on that first bit of action. Anytime though is going to swing right in, and he gets down. Static finishes him off. And now it's all left on the shoulders of Iagator. The Ash will swing in, take a head off of Static, but that's all she wrote for that round.
Part of how you play on this map, repel in from...
It's not hearing that repel go out. Regardless, it doesn't work one bit. And there you can see, another stim goes out. And with just like that, Cyclops have control of yellow, and they're going to continue to punish C9, dominating the kill feed, everybody falling except for Harper. He's inside a meeting. He knows that he's got some gunfire to his right, but he's going to be swung from connector and lose the fight. And Cyclops pick up their second in a row. Potentially put this match out of reach. There's another four Cyclops, though, and Iagator trying his best. He pulls out the shotgun splatter, Shile. There goes the thermite charge, and in springs Nova by White Van, but it's all onto Harper's shoulders. Isuzu cleans up, swings on, and two big kills for him will give Cyclops the round.
They're going to do some damage to Black Ray, and actually that'll be the finish off as well. MV Taylor manages to get Iagator, and this
thing for Cyclops is that they've been pretty even outside of that. No way, Suzu! Are you going to try for a second? No, you're going to get punished for it. Is it too late? Nova gets away with it. And now Gatorada's going to drop. The Thermite has his back turned to him, but no, there you go. Both Gatorada and Antitoon were in the same direction. Well, they've managed to snowball it right now into a 5v2. They earned a flawless round just a couple ago. It will be denied by Antitoon, who's traded off. leaving Iagator in a 1v4. Could that be it for the run of Cyclops? Yes, it can. That's a pretty swift defeat in that final round, and no overtime on the docket as Cloud9 takes the win. But Clubhouse is going to be where we play. And
only 10 seconds left. They're going to be trying to push themselves into church.
Nine players, 10 seconds, and we start to see bodies fall. They spray in. PSK sprays back, drops one, drops two, goes for the third over the top of the table, but it's too late anyway. Sexy Cake pops the first canister and dips his way closer and closer to the second even and finds the man with the diffuser around the back of the chassis. Swing round to the second, but another man is there around the corner. Suddenly, the entire site is flooded and overwhelmed by a blue. Can Liquid try and hold it in the container? Nesk drops them from deep, and PSK on the opposite side, they've been able to pull something back, but if they can't get the diffuser with Nesk continually shutting bodies down, he wins the round for them. On this rotation, decides to head in. Static caught, outsmart Pogmat, it's popped off, and so has Parlou. D4 digs two! A triple kill for Parlou, and suddenly everything has started to come back. One more than leg, Parlou! One, they're holding the angle. They want to swing round. They don't need to. Someone else is there, but Harper is able to find one back post-plant situation for the first time in this showdown. But Harper is still on a bit of a mission here.
Drone he's getting himself set up, plays the game, hits the old body, doesn't quite catch it. There's the impact!
Oh, he gets it!
There's the down! Yes. He doesn't have the confirmation! He's going back. He's not quite sure. He
Nesk,
only
you gotta
has
go.
A few seconds. Stick it, Nesk. Ooh. Stick it.
You gotta stick it. You cannot let go. Otherwise, you're gonna be tossing this round away. And yet again, we have a Cloud9 round. It is gonna be Liquid that will have to find a way around it. Of course, you can do it. Oh no, Static! From where was that? Was that pre-placed on the door? I have no clue.
I think that was thrown.
Rushing down Nova in the meantime, playing close with that shotgun and a 1v2, but it gets shut down.
Well, that allows Liquid to try and spill their way into the site itself. PSK finds one more, drops close. Shy out, however, gets the cover on the back stairs and one more. It's just PSK inside the site, but no longer Cloud9. They take their second. It finally seems like C9 have an idea on where the push and the pressure is going to come through. Nesk finds MV Taylor on the loose side. 5v3. Moringa is the first off the board, but they swing deep, find one more, and there it is, a flawless Liquid. Out of nowhere, pick themselves back up, pull.
And it is going to be Clubhouse.
I mean, you could bring a sledge. You could bring another hard breach if you want to. Nice shot, by the way, from Miracle, and now Rare in Rare form.
So instead, he'll contend with the jiggle peeking of Rare.
Valkyrie playing fun by the box.
What?
He feeds him his own skull. Takes out Anniton, so there goes your Montane. He's not going to be able to do much. Nice shot from
Gavin. No motor control, though. They got a force for that, and Heise is going to stop them. Furia gets the kill. EMP will disable the shield in all likelihood, assuming he didn't get out of the range in time, but no, he did, and that's huge. But from behind, Gatorada gets an impactful frag, taking down Rare, leaving just Miracle in the 1v3, making a 1v1, and he somehow survives the cross. 1 second left, and that's all that they need.
They're getting the opening pick because they've either been surprised or they don't know what to do next. And when I say don't know what to do next, Anniton right now...
A little bit of a wasted utility there, but that's not a big deal. They'll be fine. They do have the man advantage, and it's starting to get even more extreme as Fantasy puts two kills on the board.
Black Ray can't make anything happen. He's in a lot of trouble, though, and he gets gunned down from multiple angles.
Where Cyclops are trying to engage Furia. You know, they are working out in favor of Furia. I mean, what is that? Gatorada just peeking around in sight. He goes down.
At this point, whoever finds Suzu, it's a mercy killing. Inside of logistics, and well, there's only a couple ways out there. Manages to find another, though. Down goes Heise. Is this winnable? He'll be able to make this work for his team? The answer, right now, no, it's not. Lenda finishes him off, and it's 7-1 for Furia. This one was over in a hurry, almost
what
perfect.
What we got here looks like it's going to be Organ. So
there's still work here to do for G2, but they have utilities to try and work with. Cyber looking to put a challenge in with the shotgun at close range. Kanto finds his second there over onto Bullet, but I don't think that anyone knows where Cyber is. Playing finds one, drops the diffuser, but it is not enough. Maybe we're running out of information. Soul's playing tight there inside of Attic on the breach. A brilliant frag there that he's able to find over onto Kayak. Virtue is looking to get a plant down, but will be getting challenged. There's a yokai in the vicinity. Cameraman is able to take him down. The time is gonna tick on through. Kills come in for both sides, but they matter
not more
careful as the diffuser now is going to come in. Oh, what a crossfire established by FaZe. Cyber bait him out with the C4. All he has to do is just keep peeking away, and oh, almost gets taken out. Citizen will find Souls. The C4 misses, and Kanto, he's going to try and stick the diffuse. Uno, he catches the man flanking. Another one comes for the flank, and cameraman hits him. Uno, though, still stands strong. The two fins left inside of the 2v1 bullet. Has to climb back, but no, Kanto shuts him down. In this scenario, Kayad has been banned. Bullet finds the opening kill. Kanto, there's a man lurking on the laundry stairs. Astro is going to go for the challenge, and Citizen sits him right back down. 25 seconds to go. FaZe, eat your heart out.
Cameraman's actually inside of the bombsite, finds the kill over there onto Citizen, rushes all the way in through to supply. Is he going to be able to find a second? Yes, he is. All these kills are coming up FaZe right now. Souls finds the final one onto Uno. Could actually try and get this down. Souls is on for a triple kill. He's got massive inside of this round. Souls, you could get yourself an ace here. Virtue's found one back as a trade. Souls knows where the last player is. Goes for the swing. He finds it. An ace from Souls to wrap the round for FaZe.
Oh, no. Astro is... He weaseled his way in. Yes, he has. He's in the bombsite again. How are FaZe Clan doing this? Kayak has managed to find a kill, and now it is a 2v2. Cameraman and Bullet up against Kayak and Virtue. Kano's been eliminated by Cameraman. Kayak, oh, doesn't find the kill. Bullet seals the deal. FaZe Clan. What? I don't know what to say. G2 beaten 7-2 by FaZe Clan.
The only team that emerges from today undefeated is Team Empire. The Empire Strikes Back was something I said in a cast a long time ago, but I mean, I think it fits here as well. They looked utterly dominant, a return to form for both Joystick and Dan.